The only way is up and we're never going back. After you right now, what will you write down? Whether it be something honest or a bit profound, maybe nothing at all, babs, you're bluffing is all. Whatever doesn't matter as long as you take it as all and explode. And take that opening rift as a gift from God. Only a few of us get from intro to the bridge with hands high, you will give every ounce of your soul, body, mind, just to live. And hold on to this moment, you're in it, you own it. The zone that you're in, some kind of atonement. The song covers doing it, and for a moment you pause. And thank you to the listeners, for you I applaud.
Do
for
you want to see the other?
I have a beautiful wife, man. I'm very lucky. I met her club. I met her at a Korean club. I used the cheesiest line ever. Like, she's looking around for her friends. I was drunk at 2 a.m. She's looking around for her friends. My friend's like, hey, dude, that girl's cute. I'm like, man, I'll go up to her. I went up to her, and I was like, are you looking for me? And she was like, oh, my God. But we have a kid. Ha, who's a winner? I'm a winner. Hey, thank you very much.
A lot of young comedians ask me, hey man, what's the secret to comedy? You know, give me some advice. There's only one secret to comedy, and that is keep doing it. Nothing else.
To make the decision that you want to become a comic and you want to pursue comedy and that's your future, when the odds of success in that field as a comic, you could name 10 people in the history of comedy, maybe, who've made tremendous careers doing that. You know, and it's just, but I love it. Like, I'm an artist. I consider myself an artist. When I was 18 years old in 1988, I'm 41, I wanted to make it. And you say stupid shit like, I want to make it. Now I want to work and I want to be able to keep doing this. I love it.
Oh, the success rate in comedy, maybe 1 out of 10,000 people, because so many people try to get into it. And I mean, define success, you know, is like getting your own sitcom. What does it mean? Or does that mean performing at the Laugh Factory? It's small. I mean, even to perform in this club, it's a dream.
People, you know, they're not real with you. When you have a good show, they're like, hey, that's pretty funny. And when you have a bad show, they like, come up to me and they're like, it takes a lot of balls, man. I don't know how you do that, man. One time, someone came out to me. He's like, after the show, he's like, "Hey, man, that was fun, man. Are you North Korean or South Korean?" I'm like, "Wow, you know, there's 2 million South Koreans here, Korean American. And then, if you try to escape North Korea into China and they capture you, they will take you back and torture you and your entire family. And people are starving there. It's a messed up situation." That's what I was thinking. What would it take for someone to escape North Korea and then come here and be a comedian? He'd be the most ambitious comedian on the earth. You gotta give him his props, man. What's a North Korean comedian, man? Like, hello, everybody. I love your country. Anybody have food today? I haven't eaten in 3 days. Don't you hate it when you try to escape your country and they torture you? Hello?
I think one of the most difficult things out on earth is to move out here and try to make it as a comic, because on any given show, on any given day, on a Tuesday or a Wednesday, like, you know, Dane Cook's on stage and Jeff Ross is on stage and Chris Rock is on stage, and these people are just working shit out and killing it, and then it's like, oh, I was supposed to go second. Oh, now I'm going fifth. Why? Oh, because, and that's just the way it is. It's the hierarchy. It's a very difficult thing.
When you first start out, it's very difficult to get actual shows. Like, you start off doing open mics, and then the next level as a comic is kind of what they call bringer shows, where, you know, there's rooms where people are just beginning in stand-up, and in order to be able to perform, they make you bring X number of people. So that's how it is kind of for everybody in the beginning. You have to bring, and then, you know, your friends hate you because you're dragging them to show after show in order to get on stage. And then, you know, you get more recognition, and eventually you become regulars at the clubs. But you have to put in work. I mean, you have to write, you have to hustle, you have to be, it's a grind. You don't really have a life. So there's definitely sacrifices involved if you want to become successful in this business.
So I got on stage, I did it, it was fantastic the first time. And then the second time was great. And I was like, oh my God, I'm a natural born comedian. And then the third time I bombed so bad, I didn't know if I should go home or should I don't know. I was really hurt. But you know, that's the thing. If you feel like you have to, everyone have that voice inside. If it tells you, you got it, trust me, you got it. Depends on how strong that voice is. You're gonna keep doing it and you eventually gonna get better.